I am Sylvia Mary Middleton, and this is the story of my life. My grandparents took me everywhere with them. In the summertime, the gardens were filled with gooseberries, raspberries, red currants, black currants, and I can still remember picking them. So much for me, and so much for the bucket. It was an idyllic life. And then in 1939, war broke out.
I can easily understand how sympathetic onlookers across the Atlantic or anxious friends in the yet unravaged countries of Europe who cannot measure our resources or our resolve may have feared for our survival when they saw so many states and kingdoms torn to pieces in a few weeks or even days by the monstrous force of the Nazi war machine.
I was a 14-year-old student at Fordyce Academy when the Second World War began. I enlisted with the Girls' Training Corps, achieving the rank of Sergeant Leader. Well, the Australian pilots were noisy, cheeky, and full of fun. Well, Rex and I met at a dance in Port Soy. Rex used to fly over my house in his Oxford plane, revving the engine 3 times. We had known each other for only 6 months, when Rex was posted overseas to the Middle East in 1944, and we wrote weekly to each other over the next year. Sitting on the couch at my parents' house when he asked me to marry him. I said, I suppose so. Rex was called back to Australia for the Pacific War, but before he left and while in camp in Cairo, he sent me another letter and a parcel. Their airman's mess is of stainless steel with Italian cooks. Our cooks are untrained and have only a diesel drip trench to cook on, and half the time the food is soaked in diesel oil. And posted back to me a woolen vest, knickers and cotton interlock with long legs. I received a letter from Australia House confirming that the ship Stirling Castle would be leaving from Tilbury Docks in August 1946. It was great fun to be in a cabin with other girls. The voyage was fantastic, the food, sun and company. And I remember hearing the Andrews Sisters hit Rum and Coca-Cola being played on the ship. Sometimes a group of us would sit on the deck in the Mediterranean under a lovely blue sky singing, sailing down the river on a Sunday afternoon. On the 5th of November 1946, we were married at the Presbyterian Church Sandringham. I was a very innocent young war bride, setting sail for a fair land. I took the risk, and the risk was worth it.
Highland village, my cool dance, lonely pilot looking for romance. Scottish reel, kangaroo hopping, shy young woman, hard to stop me.
Thank you very much for coming today. You've been a fantastic audience. So, yeah, write your stories. And if your parents are still around, get their stories. It's just very important. Get the kettle on. Get the tape on. Get them singing songs. You'll get there. Okay, thanks very much.